that is business people in Western countries who follow the Middle East, who perhaps come from the Middle East, who are interested in seeing the Middle East develop, you can help with investing in the Middle East. And as I said the other day, I want to disabuse you of the notion immediately that you think this might be charity. Please, no zakat, no sadaqah, no charity. This is not a charitable enterprise. This is a money-making enterprise. You invest, you create jobs, people will benefit, you will benefit, and your corporation will benefit. And it is a very, very interesting approach that you need. And the reason I encourage you to do that is young people now in a number of Middle Eastern countries, from Turkey to Pakistan, are creating their own startups and technology and all kinds of businesses. And you know, they have succeeded. The rate of failure of these initiatives and enterprises has not been larger. In fact, has been smaller than the rate of failure of similar startups in Western and other developed countries, which is phenomenal. And that applies to both men and women. So my challenge to you, any of you who is involved in business, is to look at this as an investment in the future, not only in the future of the region, but also in the future of your stockholders. You know, that's the bottom line. If your stockholders are happy in your corporation, then you are doing well. And that type of investment will ultimately yield results for your own corporation. So it's a money-making win-win situation, not just money to be handed out. Jordan established a program of $5,000 each for young people who submit proposals for investment. And there's a committee, and if they accept your proposal, they give you $5,000. That's it. They write you the check, and you are on your own. They don't need anything from you, just to start that initiative, whatever the business you want to start. And many of these businesses start what we call in the States in people's garages, in people's living rooms. They start at home. You don't need more than a computer and internet, not a dial-up, you know, but Wi-Fi and things of that sort. You can start your business. And it has worked. And that business starts with one person. Within a year, on the average, that little business starts employing 1 to 5 employees within the first year, and then it goes on. And so that means already you have jobs being created as we are witnessing this investment. And so that's where you come in.